Hi, my name is Tim Borland, and today we're going to talk about how to build stamina. This also could be staying power, just your ability to maintain without fatiguing as you're maintaining a distance. Building stamina is going to be different for everybody. It's different than building endurance in that building stamina is the ability to stay without weakening, whereas endurance is the ability to just go and go and go. So some things to think about depending on what you're running. If it's a 5K or a marathon, your requirements are going to be a little bit different. You don't need the same amount of stamina for a 5K than you do for a 10K or for a full marathon. But some things that you're going to want to do are really intense, short duration speed work. So it's really intensity work. It's going to be it could be on a treadmill, it could be just out on a road, on a track, but it's going to be like 60 second bursts, just all out as hard as you can. What you're trying to do is you're trying to get your heart rate up really high for a short period of time and then back down. There's two things really in building stamina. It's going to be your VO2 max, which is the volume of oxygen that your body is able to deliver. As you breathe in, not every molecule of oxygen you breathe in actually goes to your body. So if your VO2 is 40%, then 40% of what you breathe in, or if it's 60% or 90%. So the higher your VO2 max, really the more stamina you're gonna have. The other thing would be your lactic acid, and you can study more on lactic acid. It's hard to explain, but really it's a byproduct of, again, your heart rate getting too high and your body not being able to handle the output. But you can actually increase your lactic threshold level as well. And you can do that with this intensity training. Both of which will do things that will help you, so that if you're out running that marathon and you're trying to run a 7 or an 8 minute mile the whole time, you're going to be able to stay with it and not weaken, because your body will continue to deliver the oxygen you need, and your body will not go start delivering lactic acid as well. So really those two are going to be the key things. And again, think about what it is that you're trying to accomplish and then how much you need to actually train for that.